This video is one of the most perfect examples of what is wrong with World of Warcraft currently. So this is from the creator Sync Weaver, right? And my new player experience in World of Warcraft as a Final Fantasy player and why I'm done. Now, pay attention to what this guy has to say, because we've spoken about this a million times on this channel. And what makes me happy about this is I called this. I said from the beginning, this is what new players will experience within World of Warcraft. This is why new players aren't playing the game anymore. I made that video. Let me just do this. Just want to show you guys. I made this fucking video. And I said it in this video. Before I even watched this guy's, video. Sexually stating, fuck the pacer test. I don't know what the pacer test is. This video discusses exactly what this guy says. It's not as long though, it's about 16 minutes, right? But this video discusses exactly what this guy has to say. So listen to this. On the video, I want everyone to know that I am currently aware of the allegation brought forward from California to Activision Blizzard. This video was being made before the lawsuit, and my opinions in the video do not reflect the current situation at Activision Blizzard. I will over add my opinion on the whole thing at the end of this video. I want to express my condolences to the victims and the longtime workers over at Activision Blizzard, especially the female employees who were the majority of the abused. As I said prior to the end of this video, I will have my opinion on the matter and what I'll be doing moving forward with WoW content. Yeah, Intensifies, how are you doing?
Hi, I'm Sync Weaver, and I'm a Final Fantasy XIV player. By this time, I have redone, reshot, rewrote, and rethought how I was going to present my new player experience to the world in a fashion that wasn't going to upset the majority of fans in both the World of Warcraft fanbase and possibly the Final Fantasy fanbase. I quickly realized, however, that the fanbase I really had to look out for were the World of Warcraft fans that had a huge opinion on the game as it currently stands.
I can't stand the game. I can't stand the people who play it. I can't stand the content creators who are still simping for it because they're f***ing all of their money depends on it. So they stand around and pretend like they're not talking shit about other games to disguise the fact that they're terrified. Because it's the only way that they have to cope. I'm f***ing sick of it, dude. I'm f***ing sick of it. I'm f***ing sick of the WoW community. I'm f***ing sick of that shit company. I'm f***ing sick of that shit game. I'm sick of putting so much of my time, energy.
I just find it funny that he was like, I very quickly realized that the community I really have to watch out for is the World of Warcraft community. These dudes are fucking nuts.
In love into that fucking universe to have it all crumble around me because perverted mid-30-year-old and 40-year-old men can't keep their fucking hands to themselves.
I wanted to be able to convey my feelings and at the same time not push too many boundaries so that my comment section doesn't end up a war zone like so many others who put out their opinions on the internet for the world to see like an open book idiot. And trust me, I know I'm an idiot when it comes to WoW for the most part, but I want to preface this again. I am a new player. And this is my new player experience. I may have not made it to endgame or obtained any good gear or had done any raids or the mini dungeons from Wrath of Legion. I also never joined any guilds, had the opportunity to craft much, or experience all of Shadowlands, but this is still a new player's experience and should be seen as someone getting into the game and not someone who has already beaten the game. With that being said, I plan to talk about my ventures through the story, as the narrative is very important to me in video games such as World of Warcraft. I'd expect the story itself would keep a hold on me, but what I found out while playing through Shadowlands and BFA was something I personally can compare to jumping in the middle of a new playing film, which is on its fifth sequel. I will be talking.
What did I say? What have I said this whole fucking time? If you're a new player in World of Warcraft, you don't have a fucking clue what this game is about. Not a clue. You're introduced to a game, you're introduced to people that you couldn't give two fucks about. You don't know why you should care. It's exactly why every single player right now that cares about the lore looks at Shadowlands and goes, who gives a fuck? I don't know shit about the Shadowlands. I couldn't care less about these Eternal ones. Why do they matter? Why should they fucking matter to me?
About the system and how I've been interacting with quests, events, and other gameplay mechanics that I, as a new player, have experienced thus far, though I can say that mostly everything functions as it should. I have seen a few graphical hiccups here and there, and honestly, as an old game, I get it. Last, I'll be talking about my overall view of World of Warcraft as a new player. I may come from Final Fantasy XIV as of this video, but if you remember from my last video, which you should go and watch, I have what might be an unhealthy amount of MMOs under my belt. I've played Fly for Fun, for fuck's sake. And remember,
I have not played Fly for Fun, for fuck's sake. Just want to be clear.
This is all from the viewpoint of a new player's experience. This does not mean I have to be at endgame or have played all the content in the expansion. I couldn't even if I wanted to anyway. This means that what I'm going through is not in-game experience or whole game experience, which I would count if I had played through all the content or made it to endgame. But we'll see if I have the push for endgame by the time I make it to the end of this video.
I still get chills whenever I hear that music. Whenever I hear that music, it's the one thing you can't take away from World of Warcraft. The music is fucking epic. Whenever I hear that music, I'm still going, let's do this. Let's kill some shit. For the Dark Lady, dude.
So, how do I begin this scrapbook-style story narrative as a new player? Well, let's talk about BFA. Functionally, BFA was supposed to be the expansion where everything would go back to zero. Essentially, it would be Alliance versus Horde once again, and that was what I was feeling during the cinematics, the NPC voice-acted scenarios, and the fact that every Alliance member is hard races to everything Horde. And trust me when I say that both sides aren't good if you play the other side. While on the Alliance side, which was the only experience I had while playing, the Horde seemed to have been coming up with plans at certain locations around these new sets of islands. The point of my character, who is called the Champion, which, okay. First off, what the hell happened between me freeing myself from the Lich King and being summoned to Anduin all of a sudden? Like 3 minutes ago, I was being pelted by fruit in the street. The next thing I know, I'm being called the Champion. The narrative around this confused me like no to-
Imagine you're a new player, right? And you come to this game because people talk about the story. That's your experience. As a DK, if you decided to roll a DK, you all remember how it is. You go, you get free from the Lich King, which of course has fuck all to do with you being, with anything that is happening in the game right now. You go into your capital city, people fucking hate you, and then suddenly you turn into the Champion. How did that happen? How did you become the Champion? Well, you don't care. No one gives a fuck. It will never be explained to you. Why? Because you're not actually the Champion. This guy haven't figured that out yet. He should. He probably will. You're not the Champion. You are the fucking stable boy. You are the one who does all the chores so that the story can happen for you.
Tomorrow, I actually had to ask outside help for a summary of what's going on in the story. BFA is after Burning Crusade, Wrath of the Lich King, Cataclysm, Mist of Pandaria, Legion, and Warlords of Draenor. Death Knights, the class I decided to be, debuted in Wrath, making my character out to be either some sort of time traveler, or perhaps I just time skipped anime style to the latest expansion. Also, for those of you who may be asking, what about Chromie? He doesn't work for me. More specifically, he doesn't allow new players to go back in time and experience the past expansions authentically. That means my escapades in the Outlands were for nothing.
The Chromie time, or Chromie time specifically, is completely wrong. It shouldn't end when you hit level 50. It should be done in such a way that you experience the whole fucking game, right? That you can experience the story. It's such a horrible system at the moment.
Exploration of the Legion areas will be for nothing, because as soon as I reach level 48, the game kicks me to the current expansion. And to put credence into my explanation here, I asked Bellular when he was doing his Q&A on stream. He actually clipped the entire segment if you want to take a look, and yes, that was my question. I asked, what is the new player experience like for WoW now, and he explained pretty much everything.
It's a pity that they throw you out of Chromie time once you hit level 50. I don't know if they ever removed that.
I believe that's completely in there, where it's just, oh, you're done, out you go.
Yeah, because it's not grave, you're enjoying a zone, and then you're like yoinked out before you finish the quest. So that is odd.
So no context, no lore.
It should have been designed in such a way that you at least have to finish the whole fucking expansion before you can move to BFA, right? They should have made the quests in such a manner that you're gonna have to level through the whole of the expansion that you chose with Chromie Time, and once you do the last quest of that expansion, that's when you can move on to BFA to go experience and get to max level, right? Sadly, that's not how it works.
No character growth, if any, and no explanation as to why I'm now called the champion. And before you guys write the explanation down in the comments, know that telling me why I'm called the champion is not your job. It's the game.
True! Fucking true, dude! It's not, like, it. I could not have said it better. It's not the job of YouTubers to try and explain the lore of the fucking game. The game should be explaining the lore of the game. The problem is that the game doesn't explain the lore of the game, and so it's up to YouTubers to try and make sense of a game that they themselves struggle to fucking understand.
Job. World of Warcraft's story, from my point of view, is very disconnected to me as a new player, and I think it's because it emphasizes on reaching in-game rather than going through a solid story, which is a damn shame. Yes. Imagine attending Hogwarts at year 6 or watching The Lord of the Rings on movie 3 an hour in. I'm so caught off guard about shit happening to me, I legit had a complaint in the first few minutes into BFA. That being, why the fuck was Jaina arrested? And better yet, why the hell was I arrested? Like, we're supposed to be ambassadors for Stormwind and they just arrest our ass. Like, what the fuck, man? Oh, an even better question. Who the fuck is Jaina?
That's the problem, right? This is a new player. This new player is meant to know who the hero is that they're fighting next to. They should know the story of Jaina, at least, but they don't. So how do you get a new player to give any fucks about your game?
The game doesn't explain anything about her to me. I get no synopsis, catch-up video, or even a glossary on who Jaina is. It just expects me to know. Anyway, I'm in jail, and for some—
Yeah, but dude, if they tell you these things in-game, you wouldn't buy the books. You have to understand. What they want is you to be as confused as humanly fucking possible, buy all of their books, then be even more confused, then start searching out people like myself, Balila, Noble, so that we can explain what the books in the game doesn't explain, right? By breaking down cinematics that also does a piss poor job of explaining it. And of course, after all of our explanations, we will be wrong because Blizzard will just decide to change things halfway through and do something completely fucking real.
Reason. The guards were stupid enough to let us out. Well, they didn't, but it was way too easy because this Finn fellow, who I actually like, allowed us to escape. Murdering my way through the prison, Flynn and I organized a prison break and escape out the sewers. We then hitch a ride back to Cold Terrace, where I conveniently can just walk around without anyone caring, even though I would officially be a wanted fugitive, but okay. And before I go on with this, some of you may say I should be in Exile's Reach, for which I have to say, tell Blizzard that! When I started playing WoW, I chose to be a Draenei Paladin.
My job is supposed to be a speculator. That's how I started my channel. All the way back in Legion, people weren't confused about the lore of Legion. People knew exactly what the lore was about. I speculated on the future of the lore. So my job then was to go from where we are now and go, okay, where are we going next? What will be the story in the next expansion? What will be the story in the next patch? How can all of this play out? That's what I did, right? My job was never to explain the lore. The problem now is that I'm left having to explain the lore because the lore isn't explained. The biggest issue is I don't even know always how to explain the lore because half the time I'm fucking confused. Like, I am legit sitting here going, well, I can try to explain the Eternal Ones to the extent that I even fucking understand the Eternal Ones, right? I'm not even quite sure what the Eternal Ones are, so I'm gonna try and explain them, but I don't know. I'm gonna try and explain the cosmological forces, even though it makes less sense than it's ever made. It made more sense back in the day when we knew that there was only one cosmological map, and that was the map, and these forces had their things that they wanted to do. Now it makes even less sense. And so everyone's just sort of grasping at straws because no one has a fucking clue, and Blizzard doesn't explain what it is, right?
Worgen, Death Knight, and a Night Elf Demon Hunter. None. I repeat, none of them start off in Exile's Reach for some reason. I don't know where the island is, I don't know how to get there, and I definitely don't know why I started out like this. But even if that's so, and I was supposed to start in Exile's Reach, why can't I just start in my given areas anyway? This has been a constant thing with WoW folk, and I get it, you're trying to help, but take a look at the screen and you tell me why I'm not in Exile's Reach. And look, the point is that I really don't need Tutorial Island at this point. All the starting areas were fine to play in, but I do get the concern. Exile's Reach has you on a boat going to an island looking for a lost crew, and it is here where you can gain a buttload of experience, but here's the thing, I do not care for experience, but I do care for the experience of playing the game. This means going through the story, and BFA being the go-to expansion for new players was quite the head scratcher. If you think about it, I started off in an expansion where it's Alliance versus Horde again, but where's the context as to why I'm supposed to hate the Horde if I'm on the Alliance side? No narrative means no context, meaning no interest from Sankweaver. And even so, while in Colt-
he is very lost, Lexicans, and that's the problem. World of Warcraft has become basically a clicky play experience. If you've played World of Warcraft since vanilla, right? Or at least you started in, say, Mist of Pandaria, where you were still sort of forced to start at the beginning and work your way up, you have an idea of what the fuck is going on. If you started now, or even in BFA, there's no chance that you know anything about this game. And as a game that finds a lot of its allure within the lore, you can't really play the game because you have no idea. You just heard it. This guy is trying to care about the factions. Like, he's told that there's a war brewing between the Alliance and the Horde. But he still doesn't even understand why he's supposed to hate the Horde. And Sink, not to worry, bro. As someone that have played this game since Classic, I don't even understand why I'm supposed to hate the Alliance. So you're not alone on that. It's sort of something that we're all struggling with right now.
Terrace, I had learned that three houses were MIA, and apparently it's my job to figure out why? Okay, why? I do get the help in the form of one NPC that follows me to one of three locations, but it doesn't last too long before we meet other central characters. One has me going through the pirate camp, which was kind of cool, and related to a lot of the theme of Cold Terrace being a sea-dwelling sanctum. Another place had me dealing with witches and the occult, and let me just tell you, the story was way too long and it overstayed its welcome.
The reason he found it way too long, and he found it to have overstayed its welcome, because I don't actually agree with this. If you played Legion, you found Drustvar incredible. But only if you played Legion. Because in Legion, your appetite for the Drust were already being wet. So by the time you reach Drustvar, you're finally going, oh my God, there's going to be some fucking story here. There's going to be something cool going on here. This is going to be awesome. And don't get me wrong, Legion didn't have an overwhelming amount of Drust stuff. Here and there, bits and pieces of the Drust that allowed us to at least see what could become. And then we get to see even more when we get into BFA. But if you didn't play Legion, if you didn't know the story of Legion, if you didn't know the story of the Nightmare and how the Nightmare affects different characters and creatures, there's literally zero chance that you would have known any of this. Or that this would have mattered to you in any way, shape, or form.
I did find my first NPC glitch here, which didn't load in, but honestly, this was just so overbearing, so tiring, I got bored in this place, and we eventually found out who and why this all happened, but honestly, it took me out of the story. NPCs not loading in would start to become a constant at this point.
CCS, I did, yes. I played it back on beta, so when I played the beta for BFA, I actually rolled Alliance Hunter rather than Horde, so I played the whole Alliance story on BFA in the beta.
So let that be a thing to remember. I also did my second dungeon here as well, a big monster infested manor where all types of ghastly things reside. Kind of reminds me of Hallcane Manor from Final Fantasy XIV, to
it's
be
very
honest.
Similar, yes.
The last place I visited had a lot to do with ships and them being built. However, it was here where I decided to pay for Shadowlands, and the game immediately told me to talk to some Bolvar guy. Now, I didn't want to overlevel and become level 60 before taking on Shadowlands, so I immediately started Shadowlands at that point of time. And I could have stayed and did all of BFA, but I had a feeling I wouldn't be too interested in it. The story was already throwing me off with these...
Why wouldn't he be too interested in it? Because there was no way to hook him into it. He had literally zero interest in learning about a thing that he clearly isn't a part of. It's not that BFA was shit. The leveling experience of BFA was fucking fantastic. Leveling through BFA, I will not have anyone tell me any differently. The leveling experience in BFA was absolutely phenomenal. If you knew why you were doing it. If you understood the areas that you're going to. For the Horde, it was the ability and the opportunity to explore a long-lost troll civilization. To deal with some of the characters that we've come to know and yet we've never actually seen, like Buonsomni becoming a massive part of the story. These were really cool things for a lot of players. The issue is, and this is, by the way, the reason I'm showing you guys this is it goes to the Shadowlands discussion that I've been having for such a long time now. Why is it that no one gives a fuck about the Shadowlands? Because every single one of us are in the Shadowlands the same way as this guy is in BFA. We're in a world that we don't know why we should care. We have no idea what this world is about. We have no real lore about this world. We're being thrust into a story, and it feels like you joined the story at the end of the story. Because you missed all of the setup. We have no idea why Zuval became evil. We have no idea why he was banished. We have no idea how the Shadowlands came to be. We have no idea how the Winter Queen, Titan Athreus, the Archon, or the Primus, how they built or set up this world. We have now found out, finally, halfway through the expansion, how the Arbiter became the Arbiter. We still don't really know who took down the Arbiter. None of these things have been explained. None of these things have even been hinted at prior to us actually making our way to the Shadowlands. You want to know why people are tired of Shadowlands? Because no one has a fucking clue why they should care about Shadowlands. And that's completely Blizzard's fault. I spent my life in World of Warcraft. It's basically 90% of my day is going through World of Warcraft lore and looking for bits and pieces of Warcraft lore. When I look at an expansion and I tell you I don't know why I should care, then genuinely no one knows why they should care. The only people that actually fucking care are the people who are so hopped up on copium that they've convinced themselves this is fine. The fact that I feel lost is exactly why Steve D'Nuzzo wrote it this way. He wanted me to feel completely lost and fucking sort of detached from the world. Because I'm alive and this is the realm of the dead, so clearly I shouldn't be involved in the realms of the dead because I'm alive actually.
Separate locations and their mysterious problems.
When this war began, I thought we were fighting for peace. But we're just fighting.
I would rather check out the Land of the Dead than taking hours on end with finishing a story I am not emotionally or mentally invested in. For an extra clear meaning, I was bored of the story of BFA. So yeah. Onward to Shadowlands as a level 50 Death Knight. Now, Shadowlands does have an interesting story, but again, we're talking about characters I don't know being whisked away to the Land of the Dead without being killed or just having their souls going there by default or something. I mean, I don't know if the jailer needs them alive in the sense, but when the Shadowlands, when you die, you become fuel for the Shadowlands. Yet another cycle of life and death that happens when you die. die in another cycle of life and death. Yeah, I'm not sure about this story, Captain. So apparently, I am the only one who has the ability to escape the Maw via these first one relics that had me travel to a place called Orbos, a city with keepers who tend to some giant woman called the Arbiter. Her job is to send all souls to their final destination in the afterlife, a life after death where souls are supposed to live out a new immortal life. Some go to be Grand Guardians who shepherd souls in a place called the Bastion. Some get sent to a large, violent battlefield to live out their immortal life for 5 more minutes in Maldraxxus. Some go to the center of nature as a seed or plant or a reborn soul in a place called Ardenweald. And some get sent to be punished in Revendreth, where souls are tortured until they are deemed sinless. Some are just dropped into hell, which is the Maw. There, we meet the jailer who keeps our friends, or important acquaintances. I don't really know them so well.
And no, that's not true. So I actually watched these streams. He did read the quests. I watched a bit of his video. I watched till about there, just after the ballet and stuff. About there, last night, he did read the quests. His streams are on YouTube. You can actually go check it. And it's not true that it would be resolved just by reading the quest. What we're talking about here is exposition, right? I could say the same thing by basically showing you Lord of the Rings, the third movie, right? So I show you the third movie, and then at the end of the movie, you go, wait, I don't understand what happened here. And I could go, well, it would make sense if you just watched the movie. Well, no, because you missed the first two movies. So it's clear that you don't have a fucking clue what just happened here. The first two movies were kind of important to understanding the third. That's the problem. Like, it doesn't matter whether or not you know the story of, say, BFA. If you have no idea why you should even care about the people in BFA, you're just not going to care. Doesn't matter how good the story of BFA is, you were never told why you should even give a fuck about the Alliance of the Horde, the most basic of it. You heard what this guy said. He's sent by this Lady Jaina to go do a bunch of things. And then he gets thrown in jail by this Lady Jaina. He doesn't know why he's being thrown in jail. But most importantly, he doesn't even know who the fuck this Lady Jaina is. That right there is the problem, right? From that moment forward, as soon as... I can't even explain to you who the person is that you're currently experiencing the story with. How am I supposed to get you into the story? You don't even know who this fucking character is next to you. That's actually quite an important character in the lore, right? And so... You're just left sort of not knowing what the hell is going on in the story.
Well, but they're locked up and tortured. Anduin especially. You do save them for about 30 minutes until you're told to leave them behind because the first one's technology only works for you, miraculously Deus Ex Machina style. That is how you get to Orbos and how you start your journey off to the different reaches of the Shadowlands by finding the Firstborns and bringing them together to stop an anime shortage. I mean, anima shortage. You know, I'd be in a crisis if I lost my anime too. Hmm? What's anima? Well, it's a new resource that's supposedly used to help get better gear, give reason for more players to keep up the grind, and it's also what keeps the Shadowlands going, because it's fuel. You see, the Arbiter distributes the soul to their final destination. When they get there, they exude anima, the very element that souls are made of. So when you die, you become fuel for the Shadowlands nonetheless, but at least you get to essentially live forever in a new reconstructed body. So, you as the main character are out here looking for the Firstborns in order to figure out how to awaken the Arbiter, while once again solving the problems that just so happen to pop up when you get there. Well, at least the excuse is anima shortage, but I still don't know how anima works and how it energizes all of Shadowlands. Kind of perplexes me. I always thought the land of the dead in any genre was something very delicate for storytelling. Death is supposed to be the end, but of course there has to be an afterlife, which is fine if you establish rules that make the setting narratively easy to connect with the current universe. You just teleport there, for goodness sake. You're told about it by Bolvar and given very little information about it. You run around the mall like you own the place as soon as you get there and almost immediately find Jaina and Thrall having a moment as you decimate your enemies into oblivion. And this wouldn't bother me so much if it wasn't for the fact that you solve so many problems so fast narratively that I honestly think that your character might just...
You see, this is What you also have to understand, this comes from a Final Fantasy 14 player. Let me explain to you how problems are solved in Final Fantasy over the course of fucking hours. It takes for singular problems in Final Fantasy to be solved can take a few hours to go through all of the quests. And this is all of the quests already being available, right? There's no patch releases or anything like that. These quests are available. It can take a few hours to solve a single problem within Final Fantasy because you have to attain to every single step within the problem-solving sort of movement before you can ultimately solve the problem. Where I actually didn't even think about this until he just said it, but it is miraculous how there will oftentimes be these incredible problems that no one can solve in the Shadowlands, but by killing five bears, you've just solved the problem. And you do start thinking to yourself, are you telling me that there's not a fucking NPC in this entire encampment that could go, like maybe you could send 10 and they could kill five bears? This problem seems to be not as big as you guys want to make it out to be.
I'm sort of god, but I will admit one thing. The story for World of Warcraft Shadowlands is okay. Not so exciting for me when I have no context for anything, as Blizzard expects me to beat the main story so I can use Chromie and go back in time so to relive past expansions whose stories have already been retconned in some way. Like how Kil'jaeden found the Helm of Domination only for it to have been planted there by the Jailer or something. So Kil'jaeden finds the helm and uses it to make the Lich King, who would go around killing people, thereby sending their souls to the Shadowlands and fuel the Jailer. But yeah. Then you got Sylvanas coming out of nowhere with Deus Ex Machina powers kicking this guy's ass, who's supposedly comparable to the Lich King. You also have this whole Lich King thing that was supposedly Kil'jaeden's idea for World Conquest and how he's connected to the true enemy of Azeroth, Sargeras, until Shadowlands happened and the sword is still stuck in Azeroth's butt crack, and we're just gonna ignore this thing sticking out of her butt. Like, we're just gonna ignore this. Okay, like, BFA had almost nothing to do with Azeroth as the Titan Spirit who should be awakening or something, but no. We're chasing this guy named Zavol across the Shadowlands only to lose and eventually have Sylvanas be like, I serve new ones! You've been serving the Elf Army, Arthas, the Horde, and now the Jailer for a few years now, and here, right now, you'll say you serve no one? What the fuck do you think he saw in you this whole entire time? A partner? Fuck no! He ordered your ass around like a hooker at a bachelor party.
This is a shakedown.
Mr. Blizzard, this isn't going to work.
Yeah.
Blizzard.
You and five of those
plot holes.
Get out!
Sylvanas is the biggest confusion for me in this entire continuity. She was an elf general who Arthas turned into a banshee. She then freed herself only to use the Horde for some sinister death plot because of the Jailer. Like, she is so unlikable to me, it's not even funny. And what's more, I still...
The sadness of it is, if you actually knew her story, if you actually knew her fucking story, you wouldn't find her unlikable at all. You would actually not find her unlikable. But because you never actually played her story, because you never actually saw what she went through, because you never actually, you were never actually taken on the journey, of course you're going to look at this character and go, I don't give a fuck. I could not give two fucks. And I don't blame anyone for that. By the way, I genuinely don't, because at this point, I am at a place where I look at Sylvanas and I go, do whatever. They can do whatever to her. I genuinely am at the point where I couldn't care less. If Sylvanas died in the next expansion, I would not mind, because I have everything that they could have done with Sylvanas, they didn't do. Instead, they did all the things that they shouldn't have done with Sylvanas.
I have no idea what's going on in WoW. I have no idea. Like, I get what's up in Shadowlands, and barely for BFA, but I still don't know who any of the main cast are. I still have no idea why the Arbiter broke down, and where the fuck is Illidan? He's like the only character I know because of YouTube.
You are not prepared.
You're right, Illidan. I was not prepared. And now my head hurts. Listen, let's just move on.
Gameplay. All right. This is the one place that I would love to hear him fucking slack off WoW, because I don't think he can. I think gameplay and mechanics in World of Warcraft is actually pretty fucking cool.
So, I've heard the systems in World of Warcraft were pretty average. So average, in fact, that programs from third parties developed these things called add-ons. And to be honest, they work pretty well. As you can see, I have a more organized UI, but I'm just not feeling okay with all this. You see, when you play Final Fantasy XIV, you are not allowed to use third-party programs, not even ones that act essentially like calculators. WoW is on the other end, embracing the add-on culture almost to a giant, slightly slanted T. You have so many add-ons for so many things that even—
I do think the use of add-ons in World of Warcraft is a problem. I think add-ons generally ruin the original vision of what a game should be, right? And I do agree with him here. When you're a developer and you have a vision for how your game should be played, that vision is almost always inextricably linked with the game itself, right? So from the UI to the combat systems to everything will be done in such a way that it enhances the game that you're actually playing. Whereas, as soon as you allow add-ons, you can allow for some pretty silly shit to be implemented into the game, and that shit can't actually be fixed. For example, things like DBM have made raiding much easier than what it was actually supposed to be. It's ruined what raiding should have been. It's ruined the idea that people should solve puzzles by learning things. Because you don't have to learn shit. DBM will just scream at you and tell you to do these things. But it also makes for lazy design, because Blizzard doesn't have to design things in such a way that it is obvious that these things need to happen in a certain way, because they know that people are going to use things like DBM. I think add-ons should be disabled in World of Warcraft. That's my personal opinion. I do think add-ons should be disabled in World of Warcraft.
And some raiders won't allow you to raid unless you have a certain add-on to help get through the harder raids. To be honest, the add-on thing isn't so offensive to me, but some add-ons like this one that shows you how to beat a boss can feel somewhat spoiling. In Final Fantasy XIV, every raid can be done by sheer grit, will, reflex, and memory. World of Warcraft's raids seem to have RNG in the mix, which can delete a raid in 3 seconds, and I'm not sure I want to be a part of that. Like, take this add-on for instance. This is supposed to be an add-on for changing your UI to look like Final Fantasy XIV's UI. Can't get it to work, but things like this is okay for me. Programs like DBM, if I said that right, seem to take the fun out of figuring out a boss in an MMO. For example, I memorized everything.
Yes, it really does. One of the reasons I am in love with the raiding as well as dungeons in Final Fantasy is it's truly figuring it out. There's no add-on. There's things happen. Your first time on a boss, you're almost perplexed when you wipe. You're like, what the fuck happened? How did this happen? I was just hit by something. I don't know what hit me. And then you go, okay, wait, I should pay attention next time. And that you look and you go, oh shit. Okay, that made sense. Okay, I get it now. Because bosses, by the way, I was a tank for my first play of Final Fantasy. And the game doesn't tell you when to block. It literally doesn't tell you when you should be using a defensive cooldown. DBM tells you exactly when you should use a defensive cooldown. Like, literally, you can play the whole of a raid with just looking at DBM. It tells you when to use a defensive cooldown. It tells you exactly when you should move out of things. It even screams at you when you have the voice packs downloaded. In Final Fantasy, you have to take a look at the fight, but also keep an eye on the boss's health bar and the boss's cast bar. Because if a cast bar is flashing, it means it can be interrupted. If a boss is casting something and you know this is a big damage ability, the only way for you to learn that this is something that should be blocked is once it's killed you. So it'll one-shot you, and then you'll go, oh, I probably should have moved out of that, right? Or I should have blocked it. You literally just keep doing it until you get it. And everyone in the raid does the exact same thing. You keep doing it until you get it.
Thing he did to the point I was the call out guy, and I loved the fight very much. It was fun figuring out how to beat him after a few raid parties. But when I see raids using DBM because of the many stupid RNG mechanics, I don't blame the player, I wholeheartedly blame the game. I heard the one who was leading WoW was a raid designer, but having RNG in bosses that can never be told as to what will happen doesn't seem quite right to me. And I know it's not in every single boss in every single raid, I know it's only in a few. But I'm just saying, if there's RNG in any kind of boss and you need a program to deal with it, well, it just doesn't feel right for me. In 14, you...
He makes a good point here. If at any point in time, you need an add-on in order to kill... And before people go, you can do all the raids in World of Warcraft without an add-on. No, you can't. No, you can't. There have been bosses in the history of World of Warcraft where if you do not have a specific add-on... That boss becomes nearly impossible to do, if not completely impossible to do, at least theoretically impossible to do, because there's mechanics in the game that is so punishing that without an add-on, it is just not doable. Like, you will just die the whole time because it is too fucking random.
You have body language, and following said body language can help you dodge attacks that have no telegraphs. It's quite fun, but I will respect the people who made the add-on for the purpose.
It's not just, Payphone's not just Archimon. You also had the dude in Nighthold, Stargazer and Nighthold. If you didn't have DBM that would put very specific marks above your head that sort of shows that you're the same and you should go to each other, that was a fuck up. We tried it once without everyone having DBM installed. I think Boss Mods actually was first. So Boss Mods had it first, and we had to have everyone switch to Boss Mods so that we could do it, because people were just running around. They weren't fucking sure where to go. Because it is so random and it can link you with someone completely on the opposite side of the room and you have no idea where you should go. At the end of the... There's actually more bosses. I just can't think of all of them now. But there's actually quite a few bosses that have very random mechanics. Which, yeah, if you get hit by one of those random mechanics, if you don't have an add-on that tells you what to do with that random mechanic, you're done. And remember... It makes sense that it would work that way. Blizzard is well aware that DBM exists. Why do you think Blizzard have RNG? Because they're trying to make the fights hard, knowing that people use DBM. See, if people didn't use DBM, they wouldn't have to have these incredible raid-wide wipe mechanics, because normal mechanics would be hard enough, because no one has DBM. The fact that people have DBM, an add-on that basically plays their game for them, means that Blizzard have to come up with other ways to make the fights harder to combat the use of DBM in the game.
Of the whole RNG thing, or because it can just be a bit frustrating. Another issue I kept running into was the sheer amount of mobs that would be in your way for almost every quest you go on. Sometimes I want to leave. I don't have flying, and enemies seem to lock onto your character where you might just want to go and slow you down when they hit you. And to be honest, I wouldn't complain about this at all if it wasn't for the fact that almost every quest you go on, you need to go through mobs for whatever reason, and their lock-on and their range is unbelievably far. And it doesn't even matter what quest you're on. You could be finding somebody, you could be trying to locate an item. It doesn't matter. There's always a mob there to stop you and get in your way. Again, I wish WoW had a line of sight system so you could just sneak behind a mob without triggering them. Like, even from behind, they just know. Hey, I'll just slip behind you, buddy. And no. Some mobs have eagle vision and can climb wall faces like it ain't no thing, but I'm getting ahead of myself. Line of sight, these mofos, please. What's interesting is how things are virtually the same if expansions mean anything in terms of quest activity. You talk to NPC, you accept quests from NPC, who now have an immersion window due to the immersion mod. You kill things, find things, click things, rinse and repeat. It's just about the same as the last expansion on what you do, but to be-
What did I say yesterday? What was my rant about yesterday? No one should ever tell me that Blizzard needs a questing department. They don't. The people in the questing department do fucking nothing. They have no work. They basically just chill and then copy-paste a bunch of shit at the beginning of every expansion.
All MMOs suffer from this stagnation. Final Fantasy XIV also suffers from quests being stagnant. The same kill monster quest, find items, find NPC, go to location, and blah blah blah. The only difference is the story significance it has in the area. Sometimes doing side quests can change the NPC and location layout as though you actually did something in the area. WoW, on the other hand, doesn't have that for their side quests, but for the main story quests only. Side quests have you interacting in the-
I would say, to some extent, yes. I think that's one of the reasons I don't mind the quest so much in Final Fantasy, because your actions have very visible impacts on the world around you. And I would say that while some quests in World of Warcraft, some main quests in World of Warcraft, can change certain things to showcase progression, a lot of the time it doesn't really. Right? A lot of the time, there is no visible progression as you're completing main storyline quests for World of Warcraft.
Area mostly through mobs and interactable quest-specific items that disappear once clicked. Most of them respawn for other players to complete their quest, but that's par for the course. The quests feel kinda similar to BFA, but it's not really a bother to me. I just wish the side quests were more important to the surrounding area, but maybe I'm not looking in the right place, or I'm looking far too into quest functionality. While it's not all that important compared to the game's inner system itself, when you have a special event happening in a location, you usually see some loading by the NPCs. They may actually disappear right in front of you, and I'm always caught off guard by that. Perhaps it means to load the event from further away so the player doesn't notice. It would help keep the immersion while playing the game, because so far that kind of programming is evidence of some early MMO lazy developing. Another odd thing is how you can just walk right into a dungeon without a word or warning. Dungeons in World of Warcraft are not to be done alone. Now, since the level crunch and all, but far too often do I find myself walking to a dungeon and then whoops, I'm dead. 14 pretty much forces you to use a party finder through something called a duty roulette. It's very similar to Dungeon Finder, so I know the-
The duty roulette is probably one of the best things ever implemented into World of Warcraft, into Final Fantasy, and it's something that I wish World of Warcraft would have, because the duty roulette in Final Fantasy basically opens up all of the dungeons that the game has ever had, right? Like, all of it is just right there for you. And you can basically, you can do all of it with low-level players, new players. It scales your level. It's really fucking cool. I don't necessarily, Captain Swanky, my point here isn't to say that you shouldn't be able to walk into dungeons if you want to do them. I can see how for a new player it might be sort of weird, right, to walk into a dungeon, and you maybe didn't know that this was a dungeon. You thought maybe this was just, especially if you come from Final Fantasy, where a lot of the time you'll go into new areas and there will be a loading screen to go into the new area. So you might just think this is a different area. You're walking into it because this is a different area, right? And now you realize, wait a second, these mobs are fucking destroying me. How are they destroying me? Where the fuck am I right now? So I can see that. We can forgive that for a new player from Final Fantasy coming into World of Warcraft. But I do think that the duty roulette would be an amazing addition for World of Warcraft to open the game a little bit more.
But why can players walk into dungeons like that? I just don't know. Perhaps a relic of the past where people would form parties outside the dungeon? I really don't know. The Dungeon Finder is a great way to queue up for parties going through whatever expansion you set yourself on. Debuted in Wrath, the Dungeon Finder allows for a player to choose random or specific dungeons they wish to play in. You are randomly set with four other people in a party and you go inside a dungeon that is within your level. The problem here is that I only had access to Shadowlands and BFA, and I'm not really too sure why I can't go into past dungeons. Here, I'm showing it on the screen right now just to show proof. 14 had you unlock dungeons so that you were proper level when going through the duty finder. WoW just lets you go in even if the story wasn't caught up to it, meaning I can go into a dungeon that was supposed to be done in the future due to story, and here I'm wondering why they would allow that. I only have to be the right level in order to get into the dungeon. Story does not really matter in this case. Perhaps to get me to max level faster, I wasn't too sure, but what I can say is that since you have a dungeon finder, why have open entrances to dungeons in the first place? This seems like either...
Well, I would say that it's actually quite immersive, right? Knowing that those dungeons are in the world, but also what he needs to understand, most of this is built for people who want to do it afterwards, right? Old content to farm that. So it's actually a way to keep the content alive for people that wants to do it for like transmogs and shit like that. Although you can actually do that in Final Fantasy through the Duty Finder. Like, you're actually capable of going in Duty Finder, signing up for a dungeon, like an old dungeon, and basically opening it completely. So you say, I want to stay at my level with all of my abilities, all of my powers. I just want to smash this shit, right? I just want to smash through this dungeon, pull the whole dungeon and just kill everything. You can do that with the Duty Finder.
Lazy design, or perhaps there was a point to it. And if there is, please tell me, because far too many times have I just waltzed right into a dungeon without knowing it was a dungeon and getting my ass handed to me on a platter with a side of salt. Again, I think it's to form a party outside. I just don't know why they have the dungeon open. It's far too powerful for any single person to go through, especially Legion and up. Leveling. So, leveling is easy. It's way too easy. It's so easy that I literally made it to level 50 in a matter of a few days of playing WoW. And I was in BFA the whole time. And not only that, I wasn't even halfway finished the expansion from what I was told. This makes me feel like leveling wasn't even meant to have been an experience for new-
Shay, I have a problem with that argument, with that attitude, really. So basically you're saying if someone has problems with World of Warcraft, they should just fuck off back to Final Fantasy. That very argument will be why World of Warcraft dies within the next decade. That's the problem that I have when I hear people literally just sort of have this argument of, oh, you don't like our fucking game, then get the fuck out. The dude is making an argument as someone who's never played WoW and is experiencing WoW for the first time. And what he's asking for is simple explanations that the game should give him for why certain things happen the way that it happens, right? That's all he wants. He wants to know that, okay, why is the dungeons open? At least explain to me why the dungeons are open. Explain to me what is happening. Now, you could look at this and say, oh, he's just complaining to complain. You're taking this far too personal. He's not attacking you. He's attacking a game that is currently not doing its best job of getting new players into the game. And you also have to understand, this is on the back of a bunch of complaints that he's had already with the game beforehand. And Nikas, it's dumb to you because you've played WoW since fucking Classic or whenever you started. This is a brand new player who literally just came from Final Fantasy to try out World of Warcraft. You should look at it as someone that is coming in, and you should actually ask yourself, if he's having these experiences, how many other players are just not sticking with WoW? Because I'll tell you what, this guy managed to make it to level 55 before he quit World of Warcraft. How many thousands of players do you think do the exact same thing? They make it to level 50, level 55, and they are, this is a fucking shit game. I'll go play something else. Because I understand fuck all of this game. I understand nothing. They've explained nothing. I don't have any idea what the story is about. At the end of the day, if your argument is, well, then fuck back to your game, then you should be ready for World of Warcraft to die. Because newsflash, games only survive if they can bring new players into the game. If you can't bring new players into the game, your game dies. It's really that simple. And right now, World of Warcraft has a tremendous problem with bringing new players into the game. Because most new players will go exactly through this experience that this guy is having right now.
New players coming to WoW. Like, when I was little and I heard about WoW and how reaching max level was an achievement for so many people because the leveling process was actually an experience, I was hoping to feel the same thing via the story, like leveling with the story along the way. But no! Leveling with the story is if you ignore the side quests and focus on the main quest the whole entire time. And even if you follow the story, you will still overlevel. I hardly touched the side quests in Shadowlands, only doing them when I...
Shay, your argument now is you're literally taking this. If I thought that you were doing it on purpose, I would say stop building straw men. Although I don't think you're doing it on purpose. I think you're just completely attacking the wrong argument. but you are building a straw man. A game is not hard when it's impossible to figure out. That doesn't make it hard. It makes it annoying, frustrating, and people leave. A game is hard when it can be figured out. The tools are given to you to figure it out, and you are then allowed to use those tools to figure it out. A game is not hard when no tools are given you. You're basically dropped into the game and said, hey, have fun. There you go. And if you were here from the beginning, you would understand why this guy is complaining about so many things. I don't agree with all of his complaints. I don't. I think some of his complaints just, you know, might be a little bit of bias, might be a little bit weird and a little bit off, but his complaints come off the back of being dropped into Battle for Azeroth, not having a clue what the story of Battle for Azeroth was, bored out of his skull with Battle for Azeroth, then being dropped into Shadowlands, and even less fucking explanation of what Shadowlands is supposed to be. Of course he's going to be fucking annoyed and upset, because he has no idea what's going on here. He has no idea what is going on here. I think actually he would have. If he went back and he played vanilla World of Warcraft, he would actually have loved it. Because in vanilla World of Warcraft, the game is much harder than what modern day World of Warcraft is. But the tools are given to you and you're led on the journey of figuring it out. They don't just assume that you will know these things. You actually uncover and discover the things at the time when you're ready to discover it. So you're basically eased into the game. That's the thing that most of you seem to miss here. This guy wasn't eased into the game. He was basically dropped into the middle of a story and said, go. Go do whatever. I guarantee you most new players will quit. Most new players will leave World of Warcraft because there's no tool, there's no reason to learn these things. And even if there were a reason to learn these things, there's no way to learn these things. Unless, of course, you're one of those players that's just going to start from quest one, do all of the quests for Classic, all of the quests for TBC, all of the quests for Wrath, all of the quests for Kata, Mist of Pandaria, Wallet of Draenor, Legion, BFA, and Shadowlands. So you're basically taking the approach, I will hit max level, and I'll just keep going because that's what I'm supposed to do. Even though no one told me that is what I'm supposed to do. That's the problem.
A wall on my journey when I couldn't find a quest to do. And even there, I had no idea how to advance the story until someone showed me that the map, of all things, was how I figured out what level I was supposed to be for the next story quest. And to be honest, I was fine being at that wall, because at that time, I could actually do a side quest or two and experience something. Now, that's not so bad, but I hate not seeing a purpose for the side quest. In Final Fantasy XIV After A Realm Reborn, side quests became a great way to gain experience for almost soloing the story. The experience you gained was enough to advance the plot and have almost no wall to hit. Dungeons were story relevant, and side quests even had story significance. You'd learn more about your surrounding area, its history, the NPC, and why they are here.
I agree with you, Ilithus. But I've said this so many times, and some people agree, some people disagree. But most people that disagree with that is people who don't give a fuck about new player experience. They just don't want their experience hindered. But you should have a level 1 to level 50 literal new redesigned experience for players to level through. And it should be unskippable. It should be there. You have to fucking do it. Because you have to know the story of Classic, the story of TBC, the story of Wrath. You have to know these stories. So that by the time you reach the new expansion, you actually know why the expansion matters. The problem is that the vast majority of people hear that and they go, oh my god, I will not fucking do that. No, I will not do it. Not realizing it's not for you. It's not meant for you. It's meant for the new player. It's meant for the guy who literally just bought World of Warcraft, who has no fucking clue. This guy said it at the beginning of his video. He didn't even know who Jaina was. He was escaping a prison with Jaina. He was thrown in prison with Jaina, and he didn't even know who Jaina was. He had no idea. Here he is, Jaina. I'm in a prison now with this bitch, and I have no idea who she is. Should I care? Should I not care? Who's she? Anduin. I don't know who he is. He ran into Stormwind. They were throwing fruit at him as a DK. 2 seconds later, he's being referred to as the champion. And he's like, how did that happen? I was just most hated and now I'm the fucking champion. Okay, I guess that makes sense. Even though I did nothing to be the champion. I don't know why I'm the champion. Who am I in this fucking game? That's the problem with World of Warcraft.
Even hidden lore about people and places. Whereas WoW, you get almost none of that. It's mostly an NPC trying to do something, and you need to help them out by either doing the simplest of tasks or juggernaut level impossible tasks, narratively speaking, that they somehow know that you can do, like killing 30 mobs and steal their souls or infiltrate the main base of their enemy or find something important and kill the leader while you're doing this, especially after they said the leader was super dangerous. Hi, Sinkweaver from the future, and after going over this entire video that is almost an hour long, I have found that I need to correct myself at this point of time. To elaborate what I mean about the side quests and how it's not correlating with the story, I'm going to admit and say that I am wrong. What I felt with the whole entire side quest is that it just felt kind of disconnected throughout the entirety of BFA and Shadowlands, but that's not true. The main story quest is fine, they are directly connected to the story, whereas the side quests felt like they weren't so connected, but they actually are. They're all connected. Every single side quest, either BFA, Legion, doesn't matter, Shadowlands, it doesn't matter. They're all connected. What I was feeling was a sort of rush, and I felt as though that the side quest didn't mean too much of anything.
I can actually agree with that, although in some ways I still think he isn't completely wrong. There are side quests that really have very little to do with the main storyline, even though that is sometimes fine, right? You can have side stories that really have nothing to do with the main story. It's just a story on the side, which is actually something that I would have loved in World of Warcraft, even in Final Fantasy. More side stories. So these are stories that's completely on their own. It's like 10 quests that you just sort of do, and it tells its own little story. It's really fun. You don't have to do it, but it's sort of fun, right? It's fun to see this sort of off the beaten path story that has nothing to do with the main game. I would love to see stories like that in World of Warcraft, actually in most games, where I think side quests are criminally misused in video games today. Most side quests are simply there to make the world feel more full, to make it feel like there's more to do, rather than making side quests an actual part of the story and an actual story to experience as you go through it. But I will say, I can see where his confusion came in, and it goes back to something he said earlier in the video, which is, in World of Warcraft, sort of catastrophic solutions or problem solving happens extremely quickly, right? You start playing World of Warcraft, you have a problem, the problem is solved within 2 minutes, and you continue with the new problem, which creates that sense of rush, right? Oh my god, let's go, we have to solve all of the problems, and it takes us 10 minutes to solve all of the problems. Whereas, like I said, in Final Fantasy, you have none of that. In Final Fantasy, a problem can take a very long time to solve. And you have to strap in for the vast majority of the problems. Strap the fuck in. Because it's not solving it for you. You are solving the problem, but it's going to take you hours to do this. World of Warcraft needs more things like that. Not superficial fucking time gates, but actual problem solving that takes you on a journey to solve the problem, rather than just kill 10 of this, kill that mob, and problem solved. Let's move on to the next problem.
They didn't correlate with the story, and that was a lot in BFA, but they were correlating to the story. It just, you know, veered off a little bit. It just didn't connect right away. It just didn't feel like everything was, narratively speaking, all put together correctly. So I do apologize for that. I didn't mean to say that the side quests weren't connected to the story. I just meant that they felt disconnected and diffused in some form or fashion. It just felt that way. They're all connected. They're all there. I just felt a little rushed and disconnected from the story at that time, so I do apologize for that. I will say, however, if I'm going to add on to this, when I talked about the mechanics and the systems, I mainly wanted to talk about the core and how everything functioned as a game. game in terms of WoW, you know, moving your character, teleporting, all that other good stuff. I do talk about the systems, but I'm not far enough to know about the whole in-game systems, like artifacts or corruptions or whatever that you have to collect. I'm not there. I never got to that point. So that's more context for that. So I do apologize for that too. Sorry about all this. Let's get back to the video. Well, the rewards are usually pretty useful for keeping up with the story, but sometimes I feel a bit overpowered in some cases, almost like the game wants to hurry me up to the end and enjoy its award win.
This is a problem that I have spoken about so often in World of Warcraft. The feeling that you're supposed to be fighting bosses that's on your level, but they're bosses, right? So they're actually supposed to be above your level, right? This is supposed to be a boss of this, let's say, final zone. You should struggle with that fight, right? Because this is a fucking boss. You're not a boss yet. You're still working your way up to becoming a boss. And more often than not, you just end up really 3-4-shotting stuff. Bosses present little to no trouble, especially if you're well-geared, if you have the right gear. It's easy. Gets too easy after a while. Almost nothing presents a problem. And if you're playing a warlock, nothing presents a fucking problem.
Winning raids and in-game dungeons. And in that case, I don't like how rushed I feel, but I do love the rewards in the sense of speed I feel while I'm progressing through the quests. I feel as though that the story was kind of an afterthought to them. Now, from the way I've been nitpicky, you could assume that I dislike the mechanics in WoW, and that couldn't be farther from the truth. In fact, I think the mechanics hold up even after so many years of service. I've said before that I've felt rushed, being pushed to the end where the actual game is being played. I can find reasons as to why people would prefer to make it to max level faster when playing an MMO. This is because of people who really don't care for the story. And unfortunately, that's not me. I've met plenty.
You see, this is, I think, one of the key moments here. This is that thing where I said to you guys at the beginning when he started talking about mechanics, I told you, I do not at any given point believe that World of Warcraft has bad mechanics. In fact, I think World of Warcraft to this day might be one of the best games when it comes to mechanics and gameplay. The gameplay is smooth, it feels impactful, it's great. It doesn't mean that it doesn't have issues. And a lot of the issues he highlighted here, I can see as being extremely pertinent to new players. So a lot of these issues that he highlighted here, I didn't think of those issues as a veteran. Because as a veteran, these issues would never even occur to me. I would look at these issues and go, what are you talking about? Like many of you in chat did. But you have to look at it through the lens of a new player. Someone who's never played the game. And understand why they're experiencing so many fucking issues within the game and its mechanics. But even then, I do think that with all of the criticism that you can lob, World of Warcraft mechanics is still some of the best in the business. They still know what the fuck they're doing when it comes to mechanics and gameplay.
Final Fantasy XIV's story was not interesting, and has in many cases made the choice to boost to a higher level. And that's fine if that's your prerogative, but as a warning to those who wish to rush to endgame, you will have a much tougher time trying to figure out how the usual game mechanics work. And it is this right here where I can compare how I had no idea what the heck I was doing in any dungeon WoW threw me into for the first time in Shadowlands. Boosting to 50 may not yield much of a difficulty, but 60 and 70 is another thing when it comes to 14. And this is how I felt the whole entire time. However, this may not apply to everyone, and so I leave only a warning to those who want to boost, whether you are in WoW or Final Fantasy. As for me, I think mechanically, WoW as an MMO is showing its age, but it still holds up. So I've said before that the combat felt snappy.
I don't even think it's showing its age. I think it's a number of bad decisions, because what he needs to understand here is World of Warcraft has gone through a number of redesigns that have led us to this bad space within World of Warcraft. There is no way that you were a new player in TBC, Wrath, or Vanilla, and didn't know what the fuck you were doing by the time you reached endgame. Because the game put you through your paces. Leveling up was quite hard. You were pushed. You had to know what the fuck you were doing. It was the redesigns that eventually made it to where A player can reach max level in World of Warcraft and have zero clue what their rotation is supposed to be, what they're supposed to do, even what their role is supposed to be in the game. Zero clue, because the game never fucking pushes you to learn those things. For the most part, the vast majority of the quests will have you press one to two of your buttons at all times. You'll rarely, if ever, need to use any of your survivability spells, your escape spells, your movement spells. None of that shit will ever be used in the game. The only people I ever see using abilities like that, we can talk about something as simple as interrupt mechanics. How often have any of you done low-level dungeons while you're leveling up with brand new players? And you can immediately see who the new players are and who the old-school players are. I usually end up being the only person that interrupts the boss. Because I know at endgame, that shit is important. You have to keep an eye on interrupts. You don't have to. I do it just automatically, because when I see a bar that can be interrupted, I fucking interrupt it, right? It's automatic. I see the bar, I interrupt it, because it has to be interrupted. This is a bar that can be interrupted. You're not punished enough if you don't. So a new player doesn't learn that, hey, interrupt mechanics is actually part of my class. My class can interrupt, and my class should interrupt when it can interrupt. And that's a silly little example of a much larger issue.
Being more responsive compared to Final Fantasy. I'm not thinking that the combat is much better than I thought, but still aligned with what I said before. Not saying that either is bad, be like judging toasters that both did the job and got it done, but one was exactly 1 second faster than the other, and the exact result was the same for the second toaster. Doesn't matter which toaster I use as long as I get my waffle. I need it for chicken. The combat feels good, just as 14 felt good too. I would say other games does combat much better, but for top-of-the-line MMOs like these, I felt that WoW was fast and paced.
See, I don't actually... This is the one part that I do actually disagree with him. This is the one part that I do actually disagree with him. To my mind, Final Fantasy and World of Warcraft does combat exactly how I want it in an MMO. I don't like action combat. I find action combat incredibly tedious for me. I prefer tap targeting. So, yeah, this is the one part that I will just absolutely disagree with him. I don't think that any other game does combat as well as Final Fantasy or as World of Warcraft for respective differences. They're not the same, but I like both of their combat designs. Class design is a different discussion, where I think Final Fantasy leaves World of Warcraft in the dust. But for combat design, I think WoW and Final Fantasy does the job that I want it to do. I prefer tap targeting. I don't want to do action combat. And for those of you that don't understand why, I'm playing at 200 plus MS. Action combat is miserable for me because I play from South Africa. So if I want to hit something, I have to also figure out what the latency is going to be and then aim exactly at the place that they're going to be or that they were in order to actually hit the thing. Because I'm not going to be able to hit it if I aim on top of them. Now, there are games like ESO that have made it sort of easy, so it's sort of snapshots, and if you were on the target at the time of casting, it will still hit, but even then, it can be really finicky, and you still manage to hit the miss certain spells just because you can't actually fucking hit it because your MS is just too high. So for me, personal opinion, I prefer tap targeting as a design philosophy.
Which gave a feeling of snappy action. Final Fantasy XIV isn't as fast in terms of GCDs, but people soon realize that when you reach level 70, you're now using a kit that requires the use of off globals, in between standard globals. This is also present in WoW, but I feel it's not as prevalent in there as it is in 14. Where 14 has you doing one off global as a usual thing, skill players are often using what is called double weaving. That's when you use two off globals between your standard global. This is a very usual thing when it comes to the raiding scene. Hell, some even do triple weaving, but I think you would require skill speed or spell speed to pull that off. For example, I play as Frost Death Knight and had used Blood and Unholy while trying to figure out the difference between the three.
To answer the question, Eleanor, you asked the question, new players won't use defensive cooldowns, veterans won't, so what's the difference? The difference is, how am I being prepared? Look, we have to define what is leveling in a game, right? If I'm going to be leveling in a game, what the fuck am I leveling? What is the purpose of leveling? The purpose of leveling is to prepare me for endgame, right? It's to get to endgame and to prepare me for the ultimate journey that I'm going to be going on, right? If I'm not being prepared, then there's no need. There's no need for it. Right now, in World of Warcraft, you could absolutely remove the leveling experience and nothing would be lost, because new players reaching max level would be as lost if they were at max level just instantly as they would be if they just leveled to max level normally, because you're never asked to actually learn how to use your ability toolkit, your class toolkit, where that should be part and parcel for what a game is. I should be forced to learn how to use my toolkits. If you don't use your ability toolkits, then what's the point of having those ability toolkits if you're only going to learn how to use those once you hit max level? And now you're dealing with a whole new slew of issues, because now you have to figure out how to play your class. So what was this leveling experience for? If I only now learn how to play my class, then why the fuck did I go through all this problem? Shay, I can play FPS. A lot of FPS also use the technology of networking a lot better. Plus, you sort of, like I said, I have to learn. It's not like I can't play action combat games, right? I've played ESO for a long time, but it takes time, because I have to learn where exactly do I aim on a moving target to ensure that I hit the moving target. So I sort of have to lead the moving target far more than what, say, a normal player with a normal MS would have to learn, because I have to equate for bullet time, for example, plus server latency. So it's like it's extra. I have to lead even more, and then it's also very much dependent on the exact moment that I take the shot, because if there's any packet loss at that exact moment, obviously I miss because I wasn't leading enough according to the server. So it is finicky and it is hard, but almost every FPS, popular FPS at least, have local servers. So there I'm playing at like 10 ms, so it doesn't matter. I'm probably not going to play Deathloop, Elodie.
Blood is a tank spec and uses some defensive abilities to maintain itself in battle. Frost uses ice magic to deal damage in all types of ways, usually very heavily. And Unholy is the pet type, summoning minions to deal heavy off damage and using other abilities to power up and summon more minions while dealing dots and direct damage. Basically, this game's summoner. Now, the combat in World of Warcraft feels very...
It's clear he did not play a warlock. His warlock would be more similar to this game's summoner, but okay.
Pretty good, and I will admit that. The animation doesn't blind me when I hit a button, so I will give WoW its credit for having solid combat. Yeah, nothing bad to say here at all. I will have to say this again, but I did not make it to endgame, so I have no PvP experience. I have observed PvP with other WoW content creators, but when I look at it, I will have to say that it just does not seem to fit me. I'm just not that kind of person to be into PvP when it comes to MMOs. Not
That's
a real
fine.
Miss if all I wanted is the experience of playing WoW, but maybe someday I'll give it a try. I'd say
PvP isn't for everyone. I'm a veteran WoW player and I don't really care for PvP at all. PvP doesn't bother me one bit, one way or the other. So, you know, it is up to everyone. Garuda, how you doing? I don't think WoW PvP is for everyone. It is, it's a whole different beast.
Try it very soon, since PvP is a big thing in WoW, along with raiding. So, for the WoW vets out there, I will now shill my Discord so that you can see the opinion of one WoW vet who told me everything wrong in Shadowlands as it stands right now. This person had been playing World of Warcraft for a while and made it to endgame. So, if you want to check it out, come to my Discord so you can all agree how WoW is becoming the worst thing ever. Also, please try to keep it civil in there. We're all about the chill times in my Discord, so try to keep y'all ignorant sides in check if you don't mind.
You literally shilled your Discord in a video that WoW players will watch and you asked them to remain civil. This dude is such a little puppy to the World of Warcraft scene. Civil? In World of Warcraft? Bro. Lol. Like fucking lol. There's no civil discussion is when you don't call the guy cunt twice. That's what civil discussion is in World of Warcraft. Like, I'll only call you a cunt once. There's no such thing as fucking civil in World of Warcraft. What are you talking about, bro?
Overall, though, WoW is 17 years old now, so I can't expect it to be smooth like butter, as told by Chop Chop Master Onion all the time. And again, I have to remind you that this is coming from a new player's point of view, not from endgame, so I have to really emphasize this. I've learned that add-ons is not something to evade or fear, but to embrace. Because the community in the game itself embraces add-ons, I felt that not looking into it would have been a waste.
But Christ, do you have a lot of fucking add-ons. Why do you have sexy map with Alv-UI? Like, for the love of fuck, bro. Alv-UI already has the map. You don't need sexy map for that as well. Also, nameplates. Alv-UI will have the nameplates for you. You're using the wrong nameplate one there. Mike's battle scrolling text. MSBT, I think that is what it is. Mike's battle scrolling text. You have mixed battle scrolling. Why? Final Fantasy has that. Not Final Fantasy. Alv-UI already has that. Mass Final Fantasy, that's your fucking problem. Immersion, I don't use it, but it's all right. Dynamic cam, again, not really something that you need to use. Weak auras is fine. Glass doesn't need to be used. Alv-UI is fine. You have a bunch of add-ons that is unnecessary. But anyways.
Though I do still prefer going vanilla when it comes to the game's standard functions, I will try to see if I can find more things to make playing WoW even more fun. I've also learned that World of Warcraft is just old. Honestly, they may want to start thinking about making a sequel to World of Warcraft. No offense.
So I think this is where we should maybe talk slightly. Not that I disagree with him. I think World of Warcraft is old and they could look into making a sequel. But if we're going to go off of looks... I would say World of Warcraft zones look far better, even the old ones, than Final Fantasy zones. So let's not start throwing stones here in our glass houses. World of Warcraft is old, sure, but Final Fantasy isn't fucking young either. It's not like Final Fantasy is sporting that new Unreal Engine 5 fucking graphics, right? I would say in this instance, I think it's sort of a personal thing. Maybe I don't really care for the graphics. I think the graphics in World of Warcraft is just fine.
Hence, it's a fun game. Well, for me, that is, since I'm still in the honeymoon phase, but a game with an engine that is getting up there in years right now may want to start seeing a successor. So, as a new player, I am not offended by the mechanics or the system. And again, if you want to talk to a WoW vet in my Discord, or the WoW vet in my Discord, you can, once again, join it. And you can talk to them, as this guy really did leave a wall of text explaining why Shadowlands...
I don't know who this guy is, but I will also say, let's not stop putting too much, sort of saints or meaning on the word WoW vet. I have met WoW veterans that are fucking morons. So, you know, not saying this guy's wrong. I have no idea. I didn't read his fucking post, but you know.
And it just did not work.
The journey and conclusion. All right. For the Dark Lady. When you see Sylvanas, you have to say For the Dark Lady.
So, this last section has been rewritten over and over again. It was totally different before the lawsuit between Active Blizz and the state of California in the United States came to light. In the last section, I was essentially in the honeymoon phase of WoW, and I left it at that because I wanted you to have my genuine feelings on the game from the perspective of a new player. The only thing I really did not like was the story's disconnecting plots. For a long time now, I thought the negativity surrounding World of Warcraft was probably because the dev team most likely was not motivated to make a good game, but to make a game that would try to keep players playing and sometimes push them into spending
true
spending more money, basically wasting their time while penny-pinching them. I had the notion that perhaps the devs were tired and have been doing this for way too long, and that the new player experience should blend in with the end game.
That moment from Breach was just so fucking good, dude. When Ian gave that answer, and Breach was just like, oh, for fuck's sake. This, by the way, if you ever want the moment that Breach probably decided he's about to quit World of Warcraft, I think this was that moment. Like, I think this was that moment. This was the moment that Breach went, yeah, I'm done. I am fucking done. I just died. I no longer want to do this.
Their time while penny pinching them. Just look at this. I had the notion that perhaps the devs were tired and have been doing this for way too long, and that the new player experience should blend in with the end game experience so everyone was in the same pot. I had thought that the WoW refugees were just playing 14 as a means of rebellion against the company, time off away from the game, wanting to experience something new while spouting their disgust they accumulated over time with WoW. A way to the...
What the fuck? The video just crashed. I don't know if he made the video.
So apparently, no. I'm the only one who may not what yield much of a difficulty, there? But 60 and 70 is enough. I had the notion that perhaps the devs were tired and have been doing this for there. Way too long, and that the new player experience should blend in with the in-game experience so everyone was in the same pot. I had thought that the WoW refugees were just playing 14 as a means of rebellion against the company, time off away from the game, wanting to experience something new while spouting their disgust they accumulated over time with WoW. A way to deflate while waiting for new content to come out. Content that took 8 months to come out, and from what I've heard, a regular thing coming from Blizzard as long dry periods for content is not something new for WoW players. I had thought that the dev team really wanted to make something great, that someone higher was holding them back, because business is business when it comes to companies, but the truth is a lot worse than I thought. I had found out that Blizzard was no longer the game company it once was. Instead, it has become a company that makes games. From what I heard, some of the-
That is such a fucking awesome distinction, because it encapsulates exactly what I've said for so long is wrong with the AAA industry. Game companies today is indie companies. Indie or AAA companies are companies that make games. It's so fucking profound. Well done, dude.
Developers in the team didn't even seem like they were inspired to make a game to break the mold of MMOs. They felt as though they were making a status quo game, something that a 9-to-5 worker would make so they could get the paycheck at the end of the week. Some of the leaders at Blizzard don't even seem like they want to understand how the game was good in the past and do not, or perhaps refuse to address, any of the game's real issues, thinking that because it's WoW, that it'll always be okay and it will never fail. I felt, as a new player, that it catered to people who are new, like me, but without the grand knowledge of how MMOs are supposed to work. I've been playing MMOs for years, and for it to have Exile's Reach to teach what seems to be baby's first MMO is outright insulting to me. Like, I get why Exile's Reach exists, and I appreciate it being-
I must say, my experiences in Exile's Reach were not fun. Like, it felt like- it was very arbitrary, but also- it didn't really teach you shit, you know? Yeah, okay, you got a little bit of a rundown of what the game is all about, but if I'm honest, I don't think the experience in Exile's Reach was literally any different to just starting a new character in any of the starting zones, because there they also taught you exactly what the game is all about. The only difference is you got into a dungeon faster in Exile's Reach. But beyond that, and it's not even a fucking real dungeon. So you really don't even get the experience of what World of Warcraft is actually supposed to be.
Here, but so many people thought I needed it for either game function know-how, which the game did an okay job teaching me before, or the butt-chungus amount of experience that I could have obtained anywhere. Again, I'm in no rush to make it an endgame, and so many people have told me that that's where the game actually begins, which is a damn shame.
That is the problem. I think, actually, that's perhaps the perfect problem. That's the perfect way to explain this problem. It's that World of Warcraft makes their game for people to get to endgame. That's where Blizzard focuses. They focus all of their efforts on endgame. When in reality, the whole point of a game is the experience. An experience has to start at level one. The journey. The way of getting there, right? That should start at level one. Because that's where you build that commitment with your player that will turn them into a payer for years to come. The reason so many of us are finding it so hard to actually dive out of the game, right, and stop giving them money is because a lot of us had that experience with WoW growing up with it, being in sort of enthralled into the game from day one. You were on that journey. I experienced Classic when it was Classic. I experienced TBC when it was TBC. I experienced Wrath when it was Wrath. So I went on this fucking journey from day one. So it's very hard for me to break away from this game because I remember all of those things. I have memories that are fond because I experienced all those things. And the challenge that every new MMO has is allowing new players to also form those memories. This is again where I think Final Fantasy is, WoW, just miles ahead. Because as a new player in Final Fantasy, you will experience ARR exactly as ARR players experienced ARR. Not exactly. Quests have been redesigned and they have actually cut down a lot of quests, but you'll still experience what those players experienced. In Heavensward, you'll experience what people experienced when Heavensward was the only expansion. So you're taken on that journey and you're allowed to form that nostalgia from day one, which means that you're probably going to stick with the game for much longer than what, you know, people in WoW will stick with.
Because I want to experience the history of World of Warcraft. I want to know its backstory. I want to know who are these people I'm fighting with and trying to save. I want to know what the world is like and why it ended up this way. I want to know about Azeroth and its creatures. I want to know about Jaina, Anduin, Thrall, Bane, Garrosh, and Illidan. I want to take my time with the story and level in a brisk pace.
This guy is making so many good points here. Because I will tell you guys this now. I challenge you to find any game with a better potential story than World of Warcraft. I fucking challenge you. You won't. The potential story of this game, if we go back to Classic and we play through all of Classic, the story of this game is in fucking sane. It's so big, so huge, so emotional. It's a shame that people don't get to experience it. It's a shame that people don't get to experience what this game has to offer. All of the incredible moments that this game has to offer. It's a shame to me that new players will never get to experience the Wrathgate. It's a shame to me that new players will never get to experience the first time we saw an old god and we took down C'Thun. It's a shame to me that new players will never get to experience the first time you fought Illidan or the first time that you fought Arthas. It's a shame to me that people will never experience Yogg-Saron and his whispers about the future and the past of World of Warcraft. It's a shame to me that new players will never experience the Well of Eternity, Illidan, Malfurion, Tyrande, Sylvanas, the stories of the Blood Elves, the stories of the Forsaken. It's a shame that new players will dive into a game where the majority, 99% of the game, is dead to them. It just does not exist for them anymore. That's a shame. That's a fucking shame. Because those are the stories that's worth telling. Those are the we're not even getting into the MOP stuff and all of the incredible stuff that you would experience if you actually played through MOP and you actually experienced what Mists of Pandaria brought to you. Legion, even to some extent BFA and the stories that BFA could have told. It is a fucking shame.
Expansions, because it feels like it wants me to forget those. I want to know about the inner workings of the lore, the universe, and why my character exists. I just want to know the story. The best part about playing a fresh MMO is the discovery of all these different types of things. How to fight, how to craft, seeing the sights, and experiencing the story. For me, the story is the most important thing. I'm not here for just the raids and PvP content. I'm here to find out why Sylvanas is working with the jailer, why do the first one's relics only work for me, and why I'm supposed to be so important if every other character overshadows me in importance, especially since they were the ones kidnapped into the Shadowlands. But most of all, I'm playing World of Warcraft to see why so many players were leaving and what it was like for many of the refugees to play World of Warcraft in modern times. I'm not here to obtain the same feeling they got the first time they played WoW 10 or 15 years ago, because that will never happen. I'm also not here to make Final Fantasy 14.
I want new players, Eleanor, to experience the incredible pussy that is Tyrande. Tyrande, where are you? Tyrande. I want them to experience that, and I want them to realize that Morfyrian is basically a bitch. In before everyone goes, that wasn't him, that wasn't him, oh my fucking god, that wasn't him.
Looks so much better in comparison. 14 has its issues, a ton, in fact. Even the new player experience could be better in 14, and in a way, it kind of has. Like how the main scenario quest for A Realm Reborn yields more experience.
Silver Coppin, did you just fall for the trap? Did you just fall for the trap? Alright. Just want to make sure that you know that you fell. That you failed this one.
And gear is easily obtained while you go through your journey to level 50. 14's new player experience for me was slow since I came from 1.0. I came from a 14 that had no expansion, no A Realm Reborn, and no clue as to why 11 was so popular. I say this because 14 1.0 took a lot from 11, and I know a lot of people play Final Fantasy 11. Just bringing that into modern times didn't cut it. I wanted to know WoW a bit better, and unfortunately, I did. I found the game real fun and enjoyed my time, but as a veteran MMO player, I easily saw the cracks it was trying to hide, and to be honest, if the narrative was much better connected without the obvious plot holes, I would be saying that WoW lives up to its legendary status. If I didn't learn about the system and how it's trying to keep new and elite players from leaving with its amazing raids and epic story, I would be saying that WoW is a pretty solid journey. But I can't. WoW suffers from trying to keep an agenda going for all players. Retention. With the top 5% and bottom 5% being the only ones really enjoying what's going on here. I can say I understand why so many have left, and after hearing the stories as to how WoW is treating players within the game, being disrespectful to their time and treating people like numbers. The only reason why I never saw or felt any of this was because I was having too much fun with their smoke screens and illusions. But the wonder eventually fizzled out, and I soon found myself skipping story for progression and rushing to the next voice cutscene with badly animated models. And that was only the WoW experience, new player experience. As for the lawsuit that's underway, I can only speak of this.
Alright, I don't want to hear more covering of the lawsuit. We've covered that thing to fucking bits. I think if there's anything to take away from this, and I realize this has been an hour and 40 minutes experience for most of you, since yes, I pause a lot. But if there's anything to take away from this, and literally the only thing that I would take away from this, it's that World of Warcraft do not work for new players. The way WoW is set up is not friendly to new players. It gives them no reason to care or even love the game in any way, shape, or form. It works for a tiny minority of players, which would be the people that play MMOs only to do very specific things. So you get players who only care about PvP, people who only care about dungeons, or people who only care about raids. It works for them, because they're gonna skip the story anyways, right? They're just gonna power through, beat as much fucking shit as they can, so they can get to the end game and do the stuff that they want. But for a new player that doesn't know what to expect from the game, really, that's just getting in, they don't really know if they're in it for the story, or if they're in it for the long run, or if they're in it for the dungeons or the raids. There's no reason for them to keep playing WoW, because there's no reason given by the game for them to keep playing WoW. And I don't think that's me being unfair to Blizzard Entertainment. It's their failure, and they have to figure out how they're going to fix it.